to society here at the book signing.
Yeah. Senior Paul Rowe, James Brown, Harry Bridges, Elijah Muhammad. That's the name, that's just the name of you.
Hi, baby.
And what's your name again?
Brother Clarence.
Clarence Thomas, right?
You won't forget that name. Right.
So you help.
I'm the good one.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
That's a blessing that you was able to keep that book and put it together.
Yeah.
Also, your wife, I talked to your wife, she said she
helped. Oh, man, yeah.
All right, great. Right. Here at the Black Repertory Theater.
To hear what I don't hear.
Sister Sadie, you know, over here.
That ain't much. I don't hear much.
I've been knowing this sister for a long time. So how long did it take you to work on the book?
I'm sorry?
How long did it take you to put it together?
Not quite a year.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Great. That's great, brother. All right.
Yeah.
Appreciate it. We're here at the Black Repertory Theater. Has a lot of history here.
Paul Robeson, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, yeah, James Brown.
All right, okay. There's two sisters here at the book signing. Okay.
Gene has it.
Huh?
Gene has it.
Deem Hammond.
Has it. H-A-Z-Z-E-R-D.
All right. Brother gave me a lot of good information about my trial. So I'm a...
Yeah, when was your trial?
It was in 19... When?
Who is? When?
Well, the first one or second one?
All of it. How far back was your trial?
Oh, the last one... Well, first one was in 1976, I think.
And so when did they dismiss your case?
1980, I think 81.
And your
case? 11 years.
Okay, and so 1981, and your case, you were physically assaulted by the Berkeley police officers, correct?
Right.
And you did not realize you, and they dismissed your case after three trials, right?
What's that?
They dismissed your case.
Right.
After
because they had a hung jury.
They had a hung jury. Okay.
In both second trials, I mean second and third trial.
Right, and you didn't realize that there you were entitled to damages because of what you suffered, and now you're currently in a wheelchair.
Well, I had a lawsuit, like I said, I didn't pursue
it. You have the lawsuit.
I did. I put a lawsuit. It was a $15 million lawsuit, but you know you couldn't pursue it until after the criminal
trial. After the criminal trial.
But so after the criminal trial, I was over.
And what happened
and
after the criminal trial?
Since I wasn't found guilty.
What happened after the criminal trial? They dismissed the case.
Yes.
Okay.
And then I didn't pursue the
civil damages.
Yeah, because I was tired.
Okay.
I was tired.
Now you done woke up.
All right. Good. I know you.
Wait. You just know me because we brothers. I'm right.
All right.
We're brothers.
All right. I'm just going to
Sir,
I won't hold that against you.
Junior.
You know, don't you?
Lionel B. My father was Lionel Joseph. I am. That's funny. My father always distinguished ourselves that way.
Everything I own is in bags.
I use mine.
Roosevelt Harris, who has contributed so much to ILW Local 10. Mean that, man.
Mary Kay.
Pete Daly. Carlos Daly. His daddy was a winch driver on the day side. Now let me tell you who's been an excellent job. Buster's son, Trent. Man, Local 10 is going to get so much out of that doggone local negotiation. We're going to get Manning. We're going to have the Port of Local. It's going to be the first port of call for several shipping companies, which means that there will be callbacks.
What else?
Yeah, callbacks. And there's no more holdouts. They have what they call flex. Yeah, so guys will be ordered for 6 o'clock. And if they don't need them, they still don't get paid. So who the hell is going? Some tremendous, by the way, Juneteenth. Is an overtime holiday pay. No work will be performed on that day. That came from Local 10. So this is Buster Jr. Yeah. So all of the guys, Leo Robinson. Well, you know, Leo received the Nelson Mandela Humanitarian Award, the South African ambassador came and presented that to his wife, Johnny.
Are you signing books? I know my cousin.
Oh man, so many wonderful things. But so much of this has been predicated on Longshoreman's son. My grandfather was Lee Edwards. He worked in an all-white gang. They called it Pretty Lee Street.
She brought a charger, but I can't put it in here.
Robert Hart.
Give it to her. She can do it.
He worked for SSA on the day side. He was a top pick. That was my. He came down in 65.
So he must be the one.
Then I came down in 1985.
That's something every now and then. I've seen him. Yeah.
He came down to 65. Okay. With Philip Alley. Yeah, he's in it.
Yeah, that's what he told me.
Yeah, he's in it.
Yeah, he told
me. Yes. Now, he grew up with my sister.
No way.
Yeah, he was in, my sister's 3 years younger than me.
Oh, man, I should have told
you. Yeah. And he knows my mother very well. His sister, Paula Martin. A dedicated ILW Local 10 member in solidarity. All right, so that's yours. I'm going to put your name on it and make sure. And then the other one is Yolanda Taylor. Is she a long term worker?
Yeah, that's her. But she's still.
All right, Yolanda Taylor. Really much in the know.
Okay. Where's Sister Broussard? I got to sign her book. Yeah.
All right, now.
Thank you.
So much.
All right. Oh, sure. Yeah, I will. Okay, all right. Sister Broussard. Are you Brad Broussard's widow?
I'm your cousin.
Cousin, okay. All right. You had a relative on the walking boss. The relative of yours who was the walking boss of the ILWD. He was Judge Broussard's brother.
Oh, see, wow.
He was the one that. Yeah. Thought maybe perhaps you were connected with the church.
No, I was
connected to my own
in the my English teacher in Woodrow Wilson in the 8th grade. Yeah, she did not play. And then later on, I became familiar with her as a poet and a writer. Well, here he's from somewhere around there. Yeah. Well, you know, she's a writer. We got married when we were at San Francisco State.
Wow.
And I fell in love with her when she was on stage reciting poetry. But even before that, she was responsible for me getting into San Francisco State. She was very active in the Black Student Union. Yeah, yeah. And so we have a grandson who's on his way to Ramanan University in Honolulu. And we have a son together. His name is Juno. What is Shirley's last name? Henderson. She was Miss Bronze. Yeah. Because I went to the pageant.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. Boy, I tell you, that was really great. But I remember you. You were quite popular. You were quite popular. A friend of mine who just passed away. Were you familiar with Elza Minor? Elza, ELZA MINOR. He was from New Jersey. He worked in anti-poverty programs here in the city of Oakland. And so he was saying, do you know who Joycey Mack is? Remember Joycey Mack? She was really popular, wasn't she? And so were you.
Right there.
Oh, I thought
I was
here.
Yeah.
Come here.
Mom did a great job. My mom did a great job.
All right.
At the book signing, okay. Yes. I'm doing that.
Oh, sure, absolutely.
He did.
And, is your name on the poster?
Yeah, it's inside the car. Oh, no, there it is for my car. I didn't
do it. I know. I'm sorry.